Hello guys, this is Akash Patel. Welcome to the tutorial. Today we are going to see how we can develop a drawer menu same like Android devices. So let's start. You can see that for that we are using a KYDrawerController library. So I have used a pod. You can also use it by pod, or you can drag and drop the library files from its source code. And now I will show you the project. You can see that I have three view controller files: view controllers, view controller 2 and view controller 3, and the fourth one is for the drawer controller, which will be our menu. Now in main.storyboard you can see that there are four controllers. First one, view controller, view controller 2, view controller 3, and last one, drawer controller, which has implemented a table view. Now every view controller, every three view controller has a menu button, and you can see that it has attached to action. So there is a target for that, and that target is this button menu pressed. In every view controller you can see that the same action is provided to the button. Now to configure our drawer menu, we are configuring our drawer menu at the time of initialization, at the time of app launching. So let's start. Our code will be in the DidFinishLaunching method. First of all, we will implement the KYDrawerController. So it is implemented. Now same as the window, because window is accessible in the each class. Once you define a object of app delegate, and then you can use this window object with the object of that app delegate. Now same like that, we will define a drawer controller object so that it will be accessible from all classes. Now it is a KY drawer controller, and we will initialize it here. So it asking for drawer direction, so we are going to use the left direction and the drawer width. So for now I am taking a 300 pixel. You can change it by your need. Now first of all, we need two view controllers. For one, which will be the top view controller of the drawer menu, means it will be the home screen, and the second one, which will be the menu controller. So let's define it. I would like to see you that show you that. You can see that the storyboard ID has given to all view controllers, like screen 1, screen 2 and screen 3 respectively. So now we will use the storyboard ID. So first of all, we will create a storyboard object. The storyboard object has been made. Now with the use of that, we will create two view controller. First of all, main VC, and it will be the main screen, home screen, and I'm using this as a home screen, so it will be a screen 1. Now let's define a screen 1 object. Let's take a storyboard and instantiate with view controller identifier and provide the storyboard ID screen 1. Now let's take a drawer menu view. We can identify, so let's see the storyboard ID of the drawer menu, and you can see that the drawer menu storyboard ID is drawer. So I'm just copying it and pasting it here. So our two view controllers are ready, main VC for the home and the menu VC for the menu view controller. Now let's access the object of drawer controller we have made. Now self dot drawer controller and dot main view controller, and just pass this main VC there. So it's done. And now drawer controller dot drawer view controller and just pass that menu VC. So it's done. Our drawer controller is ready. Now we need to show it to the user. So we will change the root view controller of our window. So self.window.rootViewController is equal to self.drawer. So it will change the drawer controller as a Windows root view controller. And also don't forget to write this line self.window.makeKeyEndVisible. Okay, so it is done. So let's see how it's going to work. Let's run the project. And you can see that now on the click of menu button, it is going to do nothing because we have not apply the coding part of it. But you can see that by swiping, the drawer menu is opening, but we have don't set any drawer state. So it will be good if we go further. Now first of all, on the click of button menu at screen one, let's take first of all the object of app delegate, so we can access the drawer controller object we have defined there, same like a window. So now we will take the app delegate object and let's initialize it. Okay, so it's ready, and now we can access the drawer controller of app delegate and also set the drawer state here. And on the click off, we need a drawer menu opened, so we will set opened state here and animation true. Now let's run the project. You can see that on the click off menu it is opening, but on this drawer menu need to be implemented yet, because we have just created a table menu, table view with the array. This it is pending with the method did select row at index path, so we will do it later. You can see that same code we will copy and paste to the other view controllers, so action will be remain same. So every view controller has a menu action ready. Now let's focus on the drawer view controller. Now in the did select, first of all we will create a object of app delegate so we can access the drawer controller. Now let's use the switch case for the index part dot row, and for the zero first case zero. What we will need to do is we need to create an object of first view controller with the use of screen one. So let's say screen one here and use the storyboard object and screen one. You can also apply as view controller here and just set the drawer menu's main view controller as the screen one here. So app delegate dot drawer dot main view controller, it will be a screen one on the click of first menu. Now we will copy the same code for the case one also. So this case one, which if the screen 2 option is selected, so we are changing the just the number. Screen 1 will be screen 2 now, and here it will be a view controller 2. So it's ready, and now in the default we will make an object for screen 3. So it's ready with the screen 3 object. Now also write a break. That's it. And don't forget to close the drawer menu. Once the user select any option from the menu, then drawer should be closed. So we can write appdelegate.drawer.set drawer state. Now the state will be closed and apply the animation here. Now let's run the project and see how far we have gone. You can see that on the click of menu. Now screen 2 is appearing on the click of menu button, drawer menu is appearing, and on the click of 3. Hold on a second. Yes, here the object will be view controller 3. And on the click of screen 3, you can see that every screen is working. And you can also open the drawer menu by the swipe gesture from the edge of screen. If you want to close, if you want to disable this swipe gesture, then you can do it. So just write the state one line, self dot screen edge gesture. First of all, you need to take a drawer control object and screen edge gesture enabled and just pass the value false. Now let's run the project. Let's see. You can see that on the click of button it is appearing, but with the swipe gesture it is not appearing. So gesture is disabled now. So I'm just commenting this line. Now what if you want a drawer menu after a view controller, after one or two view controllers? Then just I will take a one simple example. I will take another view controller and make it as a root. Is initial view controller is true, so the marker is here now, and this view controller will be appear on the screen at the time of app launch. Now just take a button and the buttons will be at the center of the screen. So I'm just applying a constraint. The button title will be configure drawer. So you can see that. Now add another view controller for this. Let's say it's a launch VC. And apply that launch VC class here. And apply the storyboard ID. I think there will be no need of storyboard ID, but still for the safer side, we will apply the storyboard ID as a launch. Now just take object, just take action of that particular button which we have created. So I'm just taking the action, touch up inside, and the action will be button configure draw. Now whatever code we have done in the app did finish launching in the app delegate file, I'm just cutting it from there and pasting it over here in the button action. And here it will be no requirement for the storyboard because we already have access for storyboard. So let's say self.storyboard here, self.storyboard. So storyboard is done. Now we have no access for self.drawerController because here drawerController is the object of appdelegate file, not this particular class. So what we need to do is we need to just make an object for app delegate, just like before. Let object of app delegate and UI application dot shared dot delegate as app delegate. So we are ready with the app delegate object, and instead of self, just paste that app delegate dot drawer, because window and the drawer controller is a part of app delegate class. So we can only access it with the value, with the object of drawer app delegate file. Now and also here, now let's run the project. You can see that the configure drawer button is up here because the launch screen is on the Windows root view controller. Now on the click of configure drawer, you can see that our drawer menu has appeared. Now everything is working properly. But what if you want to go back to that launch screen? So in that case, you need another button on this particular screen, and I will keep it in the center of the screen so we can identify it easily. Now just name it as a go back and take one action of that particular button in the view controller file. So button go back, sorry. Now what we need to do is we just need to change the root view controller again, same as the launch VC. Now in the view controllers file, at the action of go back pressed, we are just defining the app delegate object first, or else we can define that particular object in the scope of class, so we can use it any of the function. Now first of all, we need to create a launch VC object. So let's make a object of launch VC. Now self.storyboard, and here we will pass a launch as a storyboard ID, and you can also define as a launch VC class. Now you just need to change the Windows root view controller, so app delegate dot window dot root view controller will be launch VC. Now this one, this launch VC, and don't forget to write make key and visible, because it will give effect after effect. Now let's run the project. You can see that on the click of configure drawer, the drawer menu is appeared. You can use any of the menu, and on the click of go back, you can see that we are back with at the launch VC. Now on the again click of configure drawer, we are here, and on the click of go back, we are outside of the drawer menu. So likewise, you can configure your drawer menu from the any of the class, any of the screen of your storyboard, any of the screen of your project. So that's all from my side. If you have any doubt, any query, feel free to ask, feel free to comment. Thanks a lot. Have a great day, guys.